Hey, what's up guys, it's Ivan. And in this video, I wanna show you how to set up the Facebook pixel manually. So if you have a website that you're using that cannot be automatically integrated with Facebook, this video is for you because let's be honest, Facebook does not make it easy for you to set up your pixel, all right? So in this video, I'm gonna guide you step by step, gonna take your hand as you guys watch behind my shoulder as we set up the pixel manually. So I am assuming you guys already have a Facebook account. If you don't, make sure to check out my video on how to create a Facebook account. But you guys are gonna go to business.facebook.com, log in, and you might see a page that looks something like this. So it's gonna say good morning, your name, it's gonna say your account, something like that. So the first thing we have to do is go into our pixel interface, right? So you're gonna click on all tools and we need to get to events manager. So we're gonna click here. Before you used to have to kind of add a pixel through the settings, you no longer have to do that. So once you're here, you can click on connect data sources. Now that's assuming you don't have a pixel. If you do already have a pixel, you might find them under data sources. Here I have a ton of pixels. Don't worry, we're gonna start from scratch. So I'm gonna click on connect data source. We're gonna say web because this is gonna be a website. And we're gonna click connect. And by the way, this is the website that we're gonna set up our tracking on, okay? So this is a website, it's using Unbounce. So it's not connected automatically to Facebook. I can't integrate them. So I need to set it up manually. And so that's exactly what I wanna show you here using this landing page builder. And this is the thank you page, okay? So for this video, what we wanna track is how many people land on this landing page, enter their email, and land on this thank you page. That's what we're tracking for the purpose of this video. So we're gonna come back here to create our pixel. Let's say Yvonne new YouTube pixel. Whatever name you wanna give it, we're gonna click on create. And now Facebook is gonna prompt us. So it's gonna say, do you have a website? You can enter a website. You don't need to enter a website. It doesn't matter. I'm just gonna say, I don't have a website, so we can move on. Now you can get guidance or do it yourself. The problem with this approach is usually Facebook will try to give you the easy way, which is via integration. However, there is no integration, right? For our example, because we're gonna do it manually. So we're gonna click on do it yourself. We're gonna click on next. By the way, you can use what I'm showing you here, the manual way, to a website that is integrated, right? So this approach, the manual approach, you can do it for anything, all right? That's why it's so valuable. So I do suggest using Conversions API. It just gives you additional data. Why not? There's no reason not to. We're gonna click on next. And then over here, you can set it up with partner integration or set it up manually. So we're gonna set it up manually, but let me quickly show you. So if you use this option here, only these sites here will allow you to integrate it manually, okay? If you don't have any one of these, you can click on a request a new partner and we can type it Unbounce over here. But if it's not here, you know, there's nothing we can do, so we need to set it up manually. So you could either have selected the setup manual option there, the third option that I just showed you, or you could just come back in here and click on setup meta pixel. Okay, it'll give you the same exact thing. And then here we're gonna say install code manually. And then here's where it starts, all right? Get your hands ready, guys, get ready. We're gonna get into it. So there are two components to this, all right? The first thing we have to do is we have to add this base code on every part of our page. In Unbounce, I'm gonna go in and manually add it to every page of my website. If you have the capability to add it one time to automatically every page on your site, that's fine too. So what we're gonna do is we're going to copy code. I'm going to go into my landing page here, into the JavaScript section of the landing page, and I'm going to paste it here. And we're gonna add it in the head section because that's what Facebook is telling us to do. It's saying just above the closing head tag. So we're gonna come back here and we're gonna name this. We're gonna name this Facebook body, no, sorry, base code, okay? We're gonna put it in the head. We're gonna save done. We're gonna hit save. We're gonna hit republish, republish. And then we're gonna do the same thing on our thank you page, right? Because like I said, we wanna do it on every page of the site. And we're gonna type in here, Facebook base code. Because this isn't a specific event. We're not tracking leads or sales yet, right? Here we're just tracking so far, just adding the code, just allowing Facebook and our page to communicate. So we're gonna hit save, we're gonna hit republish, republish. Here, good, okay? So once that is done, we're gonna hit on continue. And you can turn this on. It basically allows Facebook to, if it sees data that it already has from your website, like their email address or phone number, it will give you more information about that customer, right? Basically. So just allows you to have more information for your remarketing purposes. And then we're going to click on continue. And then this is where we're going to need to do this using the event setup tool. Now, the event setup tool has not worked for the past few years. And I don't know what's going on with Facebook. If you click here, it says no Facebook events have been detected. Even if they are detected, I still get this message. And even if this message isn't there, if you enter your website here, it just doesn't allow you to do anything. So I just copied my website and it doesn't let me open it. So it's kind of bugged. I don't know what's going on. So we have to do it manually either way. So we're going to say install events using code. Okay. And this is where this manual technical side comes in. All right. So we're going to now set up this event code on our site. What that means is we're going to specifically say, hey, Facebook, I want to track leads on my site. I want to track people that land on our landing page and then enter their email and end up on the thank you page. So that's what we're going to do here. Okay. So follow along with me here, guys. It's not too complicated. I'm going to break it down for you. Okay. Don't worry about all these codes you're going to see here. I'll break it down for you. Okay. Very, very simple. So here's the idea. Let's take a look. Let's open our code again that we added here. Okay. Ignore all this. The only thing I want you guys to pay attention to are really these two things. Okay. This line here says, let's initiate this code for this pixel ID. This is your pixel ID. I can't show you right now. I don't want to leave this page yet. Actually, we can leave this page. Why not? That should be your pixel ID. This one right here, ending in 1130. Let's see if we can get the ID somewhere here, maybe settings. Here, 1130, okay? So that's what this part is. This part here says, okay, we're gonna track page views. We're gonna track how many people land on this page. That's what this says. Now, what we want to do is we want to track how many people land on our thank you page, right? Specifically. So we have it here on the thank you page as well. But we wanna track it as a lead, not just as a page view. So what we have to do is we have to basically add another one of these codes that's gonna say lead, okay? But let me elaborate and give you some more details so you have some more options. So this is basically the code that we're adding, right? So just another one of this. Notice it's the same. This one, track purchase, is exactly the same as this. Just it says purchase and this one says page view. For the purchase, however, there are a few more details like the currency and value. But if you're doing a lead, you don't need to worry about that. So let's click on over here. And actually, let me go back. Let me open in a new tab so we have this open. No. Sorry about that. Let's right click. There you go. So here are all the different events you guys can add. Add to cart, add to wishlist, complete registration, contact, right? Donate, find location, lead, purchase, schedule, search, start trial, submit application, all of these. Now, here's that purchase one that you see over here. And as you can see, it is required for you to add currency and value, all right? Which is what you have here, currency and value. However, if we want to track leads, nothing is required, right? We don't need to add anything else. As you can see here, these are just optional. So what we can do then is if you want to track purchase, you would add this and you would replace, you know, this with your currency symbol, CAD for Canada, right? BRZ for Brazilian real, I think. And then value how much each conversion is worth. For leads, what we're going to do is we're just going to, let's come back to our thank you page. We're just going to copy this. Okay, I'm going to copy and I'm going to click enter to put it on a new line. And instead of page view, we're simply going to type in lead because that's what this says here, lead. That's what we have to write. If you want to track purchases, then you have to write purchase here instead. But you also have to add these things. Okay, so if you want to track sales, guys, then you want to go to the page that somebody lands on after they make a purchase, like a sales confirmation page, and you want to copy this and you want to paste that. Just like that. And then you want to change this to reflect your currency and this for your value. Okay, that's what you would do if you want to track like sales. In our case, we're just tracking leads, right? How many people have signed up? So that is it. This is how you do this manually. You take a look at these events, whichever you want to do. If you want to do a start trial, you would do start trial. So then instead of lead, you would just type in start trial. Simple as that. That is all. But we're going to write lead. We want to keep a lead, right? If you want to do subscribe, you want to do view content, which is already there, I believe. Initiate checkout, all of these. Write whatever it is you want. And that's how we do it. So once this is done now, we're going to hit done. We're going to hit save. We're going to hit republish. Now, the main question is, let's test it, right? Let's make sure that this works. So we are going to just save everything. Let's save all of our pages again. And let's quickly go back to our pixel and let's see what we have here. So if we go into overview, if we refresh, you might not see anything here, okay? It might take up to 30 minutes. However, there are some things you can do to speed up the process and to make sure that it's working properly. So the way we do that is, I don't think we need those anymore. The way we do that is installing something called Facebook Pixel Helper. It's an extension for Chrome. I believe they have it for Firefox. It's called Meta Facebook Pixel. They changed it. So what we're going to do is we're going to now refresh the page, and you're going to see a little green here. If we go to the thank you page, we're going to refresh the page. Now we see two greens, right? Because we have the lead and the page view. Then you want to make sure the pixel ID is correct. 1130, right? Here it's, if we go to settings here, it's also 1130. So this is how you can test. This is option one, how you can test, by having this pixel helper and making sure they are green here, making sure they're green. If your icon here is not green, if it's yellow, that means that you possibly either set it up incorrectly, go back and see the tutorial that I just showed you here, or you have ad block. Because if you have ad block installed, look at what happens. If we refresh the page, now it's yellow. It says, oh, it's not working. And in fact, it will not work. So if you never turned ad block off for your page, then on the events manager, you will never see any data here. It's going to act as though it's incorrect. So when you're testing this, guys, make sure you turn off ad block for this page. Only then it will show green, signifying that it fired. Okay, so we can come back in here. We can refresh it and see if it works. And it does. Okay, so it says no activity was received, but you can see now it changed here. Here's the other thing you can do. Okay, so here's the second way to test it. Let's do that first before we start going into and seeing events firing. So click on test events and click on confirm your website's events are set up correctly. And then what you're going to do is you're going to enter your landing page here or your sales page or whatever, right? Whatever you're using to test. We're going to click on open website. We're going to enter a bogus email here so we can move on to the next page. Boom. So now the Facebook pixel should have fired, right? And boom, there it is. So this is what I was looking for originally, but you have to do this little test for it to show up. And in fact, some events are delayed. So here is the page view and the lead that we just did right now, right at 9:54. Yes, it is exactly 9:54 right now. So that's it. That's how you set up your pixel. And then you should start seeing activity here. And when you actually start running ads, you should actually see the conversions, right? So you should be able to see what works, what doesn't. This is how you set it up manually. Now, guys, I'm using Unbounce, but you don't have to use Unbounce, right? You can use whatever platform you're using. OptimizePress, you know, ClickFunnels, anything like that. This is the process how you would do it. You go into the JavaScript section of your page or the code section of your page and you add this code into the head section. That is it. Now, the other thing is here, you will not see real events here. Okay, so you will see test events, but you won't see real events. And the reason for that is because you haven't gotten clicks to your actual ad, to your actual campaign, right? So once you actually get clicks to your campaign, that's when you're gonna see the real events here firing, okay? But this is how you do it. This is how you set this up, this pixel. If you guys enjoyed this video and you found it valuable, I do invite you to check out my website at ivanmeta.com, where I offer you a free 55-page affiliate marketing guide to help you get started in affiliate marketing, understand how it works, as well as I offer training courses specifically here for Facebook Ads Mastery and Facebook Ads Retargeting, if that is what you're looking for. But I do also offer training on Google Ads and Microsoft Ads. And that is it for this video. Thank you guys for watching. I will see you in the next one.